Oscar Bevis, IFL TV, proudly sponsored by Everlast. Casey Benjamin, you are decent at this boxing game, aren't you?
I'm all right. I'm getting a bit better as I go on.
Big win, statement win as well. Talk me through the fight. So, what was it, end of the seventh or end of the eighth? But just talk me through the fight, let's start with the first four.
Yeah, game-wise, just go out there, box, enjoy my boxing. Keep the centre of the ring. When he comes, shoot a move. Just don't get stuck on the ropes, and I think I've done that perfectly.
We know Martin's a pressure fighter. Did he bring exactly what you expected?
Exactly what I expected, but I've been sparring the likes of Sam Eggington, and you don't get much more of a pressure fighter than Sam. And when you're in there with Sam, I don't really feel like this sort of level of fighters kind of like touches him. So
I'd love to see spars between you and Sam. Now you said that, I bet they're really good to watch.
Aye, them spars, that's where you'd pay to watch them. They're definitely something that you'd want to see.
Hennessy can headline that in a couple of years.
Yeah, 100%, 100%.
So we're getting towards the later rounds. You said you hit him behind the back with a shot that the ref said wasn't a clean shot. This must be when I was looking at the back of the thing. So you hit him behind the back.
I think it was like the end of the sixth. I caught him in the ribs and the ref said it was in his back. And he kind of winced at that. But I kind of knew that he didn't really like the body shots then. So at the end of the seventh, I've caught him with that one. And yeah, he didn't want to come back out.
Come out of the toilet, come back in for the seventh round. I can just see you just boxing, doing your thing. And the crowd was lifting. It was almost like it was coming. And then that page of a shot. But the bell had gone and he took the knee after the round. So he went back to his corner and then obviously didn't come out for the next round. But it's one of the best shots you've thrown, that, surely.
Yeah, I don't really feel like I get enough credit that I deserve because I've what's that like my fifth or sixth, tenth rounder. And I feel like my fitness is amazing. I didn't feel tired once in there. Just boxed ahead of him, controlled the pace of the fight, and was just enjoying it.
I mean, all the Hennessy boys, when you talk to them, they sort of hail you as a fantastic boxer, and that is what you are. But I don't know, you've got a bit more to your game. That shot was thrown with real bad intent. You threw some shots in there with some real fucking, real power behind them. So it's like you've got a bit of both to your game. And I suppose you want to be developing that power as well. And you showed that to me.
Yeah, definitely. That's what I've been working on. I've always had that. If you look at my amateur record, I had numerous knockouts. I won the under 20 novices, and near enough every fight, I won them by knockout. So yeah, definitely I've got power to my game as well. I just need to show that a bit more.
And a quick word before we talk about the future on the fans in there. Mate, it's just, I can't tell you how buzzing I am to see it. So to fight in front of it for the first time in a while, mate, must be mustard.
Yeah, it's great. It's the first show in the UK this year to have fans. So, and to be a part of that, Mick Hennessy and Channel 5, it's great feeling, especially getting a stoppage on this sort of show. Oh, it's great.
So, British Eliminator, like we said on the press conference day, sometimes they don't always go your way. I know you've had, like we said, the English Eliminator before that didn't turn out your way. But I don't know, after a performance like that, with Mick back in your, I don't know, do you reckon the British boys are going to be looking and going, oh, I don't really want a bit of Casey Benjamin?
You never know, do you? But at the same time, I think everyone around this level is game and willing to fight everyone. So I think it's just if the money's right and it makes sense, yeah, can definitely get made.
And I suppose you want the British title shot next, if possible. So you've got Chris and Echo fighting soon. But if possible, you would want that next. You're ready for that?
Yeah, I'm ready for that next, 100%. Obviously, look at my performance. I think that shows. He just went all the way with Michael Mickison, who's a world-ranked fighter in the WBO governing body. I think he's like ranked fourth. So, and I just stopped him. So what does that say?
Is that where the statement comes from? Because look, you and Michael, both very good boxers. Michael doesn't have many stoppages, but the fact he went the distance and you didn't, is that a statement on its own?
Yeah, I think that's a big statement. Mickinson's got a bit of a similar style to me, so I feel like that fight just was just like that icing on the cake, just to show everyone what I'm about.
And Chris Jenkins and Echo will get it on, I think, in a couple of months' time when Frank announces his July shows. That's a tasty fight, that, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a great fight. It's a bit hard to pick a winner. Obviously, it's a 50-50 fight. But I sparred Chris, and I feel like he doesn't really get enough credit so for his boxing skills, even though obviously Echo's a great fighter. But Echo's last couple of fights, he hasn't really performed the way that everyone would have thought he would have. But I lean towards Chris.
Are you one of them fighters? Well, when did you spar Chris?
I think it was just after Ultimate Boxer. I can't really remember, to be honest. Or I think it was for my Levi Ferguson fight. I think, what was that, my seventh fight? Something like that.
You're obviously a different fighter, a much better fighter now as well, but do you take anything from that spar? Because obviously, like I said, it's not like you sparred him last month, because it was a while ago. Can you take anything from that, Dragon?
Nah, I don't really take anything from it. I just try and learn from every spar. I don't go in there to try and knock someone out in a spar. I go and try and work on stuff. So I feel like in every fight, you need to try and kind of develop yourself in every sort of spar that you have.
Well, look, you've done the business tonight, entertained the fans as well, and yeah, just another fight on what's been a really good night of boxing. So well done, Casey, and I look forward to seeing you in the ring soon. Be it British title, be it, like you said, an international opponent. After that performance, people will be excited. Well done.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you for having me.